Okay, this is actually being given, as the sister said there, for 6-year-old children. And I don't want to go into a huge amount of detail about this comic, and I can show you a copy of this comic. We have some children here today, and I don't want to go into too much detail, just from the concept of haya that we have. But suffice to say that this discusses the issue of the parts of the body, and there's two diagrams, two pages, where it talks about the boy's body and the girl's body, and it asks children to compare the different parts of the body. And obviously we know children have two hands and two arms and two legs and one head and two eyes and one nose, but there's differences. And so the children will focus upon these differences, they'll learn new vocabulary, they'll learn the names of the intimate parts of the body. And obviously, as you know, anyone who's got children, if my son, he's 3 years old, but if he learns a new word, he uses that word whenever he can. Whether he knows the context of that word or not, he'll use that word. Yeah? So he'll use it out of context. And with most words, it's fine. But when they start to talk, when they start to learn about the intimate parts of the child's body, that's a problem. And when they start to use those words, and they start to point to women and to men, and use those words, this is something which we cannot agree to. We cannot agree that our children will be given this at school at the age of 6 or 7, and they come back with this in their bag, and they ask us as a parent to help them complete it as homework. This is a comic book. It's very attractive to the child's eye. Very clear, very exciting illustrations. And so I think this is inappropriate for the age at which it's been intended. Now, there's another documentary that's going around, and I spoke to one parent this morning from Marlow, and he was telling me that in his local school, he got hold of the DVD that they're showing, and that's the Channel 4 Living and Growing documentary. And this documentary is not acceptable. Why? Because it goes into a lot of detail about children and about touching intimate parts of the body, and it encourages children to touch the intimate parts of their body, and say this is a good thing to do, it's all right thing to do. And this has been shown to 5-year-old children. Another material that has been shown, and I'm going to talk about an example from Leighton Stone in a minute, but this is another resource that they show in school. It's called And Tango Makes Three. And if you look at this book, it's very attractive. It's got, if I gave this book to my son, he'd be very happy with it. Because it's very nicely coloured in, nice illustrations. It actually talks about two penguins, yeah, Roy and Silo. And these are penguins with a difference, because these are gay penguins. And I know for a fact this is in some schools that our children go to. And this has been shown to children to try and normalize homosexuality in their minds. To say that some children have a mother and a father, some children have just one mother, and some children have two mothers and two fathers. And all are just as acceptable as others, as other family units. So all of these parental units are acceptable. And this is unacceptable to teach this to children at the age of, to show this to children at the age of 5. And this is not teaching. This is children enjoying the story, but... So this is children enjoying the story, but in that story, they're being taught that it's acceptable to have a mother and a mother, a father and a father. This is something which is around. And there are many more books like this. Yeah? There's a book called Space Girl Cutes. There's a book called King and King, a fairy story about a prince who falls in love with a prince. And they're rulers of a kingdom. And these are types of stories they're trying to feed this idea into. And the next slide is taken from this comic, but because there are children around, I'll miss that slide. But if you want to look at this afterwards, I'll put a few copies on either side. Please have a look at it. If there are no more copies on either side, come and see me and you can have a look at this as well, inshallah. But the main problem with the sex education classes in schools are they're devoid of values. What do I mean by this? I mean that the way they teach sex education classes in schools are not built upon firm values, are not built upon right and wrong. They are built upon many lifestyle choices. So we, as Muslims, we believe in the importance of family and marriage. We believe that family is important, and marriage is a cornerstone of family life, absolutely essential. So we believe in the importance of family life and of marriage. We believe in haya, of modesty, that children are born with a degree of haya, of modesty, as a natural fitrah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a natural circumstance Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places in human beings, as a natural characteristic. And we believe in this idea of haya, that children, babies don't like as a natural act to be left naked. That they don't, it's not a natural thing for children to be, to like, and it's not a natural thing for children to be in that particular state. We believe in the prohibition of premarital and extramarital relations because marriage is so important. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed safeguards to protect marriage, and that's why we believe in this concept. We believe homosexuality is not an acceptable lifestyle choice. And today, it may be unfashionable to say this. We may be branded as an extremist if we believe that homosexuality is a sin against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we believe it, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described in great detail about Qawmi Lut, about the people of Lut, about Lut alayhi salam, who warned his people, but they forgot and they ignored the warnings and the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and chose to act in a way which does not conform to the fitrah of human beings. So this book, for example, is being taught in a school in Leytonstone. I don't know whether anybody heard that about 3 weeks ago, a school in Leytonstone, George Tomlinson School, decided to have a whole series of sessions as part of LGBT Week, Lesbian, Gay, Bisexual and Transgender Week, where they started to have not only one lesson, yeah, but every single lesson during that week was tied into Lesbian, Gay, Bisexual and Transgender Week. And under the guise of anti-bullying, so they said, look, there's some children who may be homosexual, yeah, and in this primary school, there may be some children who are homosexual, so we don't want them to be bullied. So they need to be taught that don't bully homosexual children. Rather than saying that bullying is bad, bullying Muslim children, bullying homosexual children, bullying any children is a bad thing, they said, let's focus on homosexuality. And through the back door, they started to teach homosexuality to our children. And there were a group of 30 parents who were angry with this. And they were all Muslim parents. And they said to the school, look, we don't want this to be taught to our children. But unfortunately, there were no Muslims on that governing body of that school. Yeah, and I'll discuss that later, the importance of Muslims becoming governors in our schools. But there were no Muslims in the governing body of that school. So the head teacher ignored them. I said, no, we're going to do this. When they withdrew the children from school, the local authority, in statements to the press, in the Mail, in the Telegraph, in the Times, said, we're going to prosecute those parents who withdrew their children from that week of school. And the parents were obviously angry, and they were frightened as well, that they may be taken to court, to a magistrate's court, and questioned, why did you take your children out from school? But that is only because the head teacher and the governing body didn't listen to the parents. They got 50 signatures from parents, Muslim and non-Muslim, and the school ignored that. So they were under the threat of ban. And we spoke to the Wolf Forest Council of Muslims, and the Wolf Forest Council of Muslims is very good on this. They wrote a letter to the council and they said, this must not happen. This must not take place. They, as well as that, this brother called Pervez, who went onto different media platforms and discussed this issue, and he got very favorable press and a lot of support from people around the country saying, we agree with what you're saying, Muslim and non-Muslim. And also what we've done is that we've under the Freedom of Information Act, we've written to Wolf and Forest Council and to the school, and we've asked them to reveal all the minutes of meetings in relation to LGBT Week, all the governing body meetings, the minutes, all the communication between the school and the local authority and vice versa, so all the emails, all the letters, all the telephone calls, everything to do with this issue. So then we will find out what the issue was. And we believe that the council was trying to threaten parents as a political move, not a legal move. They were trying to say to parents, you can't do this. You can't stand up against our schools because this is a pilot project in Leytonstone. If it is successful there, it will be rolled out across the country.